If you've had to watch a friend or a loved one go through the stages of Alzheimer's, you know its devastating effects on both the patient and those who love them. Thankfully, there's some good news when it comes to Alzheimer's prevention, and Dr. Chad Larson, who specializes in autoimmune and environmental disease testing and prevention, is back to tell us all about it. Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
No, thanks for being here. You know, really important topic, Alzheimer's disease. Have experts really found out what is the precursor to it?
What the current data is telling us is that these neuroinflammatory conditions, like Alzheimer's disease, really have their root in inflammation. And when I say inflammation, what I think a lot of people would have in mind is if you sprain your ankle and your ankle swells up and it looks like it's, we say, oh, you've got an inflamed ankle. That's not what we're talking about. We're not talking about swelling here of the brain. What we're talking about is an imbalance of biochemicals in the brain. And what happens in a neuroinflammatory conditions like Alzheimer's, mm-hmm. Parkinson's disease, other conditions like that, there's a imbalance of biochemistry, and these inflammatory chemicals get kind of out of control. And the brain is such a vital organ that this inflammatory immune system is much more reactive in the brain than the rest of the body. The rest of the body works more like a sharpshooter. In the brain, it works more like a shotgun or a machine gun, and it tries to go after whatever the trigger might be. It goes after that trigger in almost an overactive way. If that happens enough times, the neuroinflammation is going to happen, and that could eventually lead to a neurodegenerative condition like Alzheimer's.
And so what are these triggers?
Yeah, there's lots of potential triggers that could fire up the immune system of the brain, but there's a couple key ones that I think go really overlooked, and they're actually quite common. One is gluten. Gluten from wheat is well documented to affect a certain part of the immune system, causing inflammation, and that inflammation can go to the brain and start to deteriorate the brain. It can cause damage to the brain in such a way where the brain's not working properly, inflammation happens, and then a condition could really start to manifest from that. Another one is called LPS, or lipopolysaccharides. This is from the gut. The gastrointestinal tract has a bunch of bacteria in it, good bacteria, bad bacteria, but LPS comes from bad bacteria. And if this is allowed to really proliferate in the gut, it could start to chew away at one of the key barrier systems that separates the gastrointestinal tract from the rest of the body. And if this barrier system becomes compromised, LPS is allowed to get into the circulation where it's not supposed to be. And there's very good recent literature that shows when LPS is in the circulation, it can go to the brain and cause inflammation and lead to neurodegenerative damage.
Now, the last time you were here, you shared with us some groundbreaking tests for gluten and wheat reactivity. Is that test also something that could help us to prevent Alzheimer's?
Yeah, Cyrex Labs, their real main focus is autoimmunity and immune dysregulation. And they have a test that's really second to none for evaluating gluten. Instead of just checking for one gluten peptide, they evaluate for multiple gluten peptides to really decrease the chance of a false negative, because gluten is such a well-known trigger for a variety of inflammatory conditions. We want to make sure that we get it right the first time that we test it. So they have an excellent test for that. It's called Array 3. It's a multi-gluten peptide analysis. And then they have Array 2, which evaluates for that gut barrier problem. It lets us know if there's what's called leaky gut, where the gut is no longer bound together the way it's supposed to, and it's compromised in such a way that bad guys are allowed to get from the gut into the circulation where they're not supposed to be. Another barrier system that we need to really care about is in the brain. It's called the blood-brain barrier, where the gut barrier separates the gut from circulation. We don't want things to cross into the brain that aren't supposed to.
Sure.
So there's a barrier system called the blood-brain barrier. There's also a test for that from Cyrex Labs.
Really?
So it's a great way to have a really comprehensive evaluation. The key thing to keep in mind here, Olga, is that these laboratory tests are the first of their kind.
And when we talk about these tests, should everybody get these screenings?
It's a good test for a whole variety of conditions, but especially if you have a family history or a personal history of any kind of inflammatory neurological problem, like if you have a family history of Alzheimer's disease, if you have a family history of Parkinson's, or even multiple sclerosis, other kinds of autoimmune conditions, but also things like depression and ADHD have been tied to neuroinflammatory problems.
Doctor, for anybody that would like more information, where would they go to?
Yeah, they could go to joincyrex.com. Join CYREX.com.
Thanks for all the information.
Thank you.
And if you want to head to our website, thebalancingact.com, we've got more information there on these groundbreaking medical diagnostic tests. That's thebalancingact.com. And don't forget to join us on Facebook and Twitter. I'm actually on Twitter.